Got a few good bits of news on the pandemic and vaccination. The most important by far, and you've probably seen this reported all over the country. I got the vaccine. And that's the most important thing. Also, one of our producers is gonna be getting the vaccine later on today. I believe Franny is gonna be getting it soon. I hear Anna's gonna be getting it soon. How awesome that so many people in so many states increasingly have access to it. Unfortunately, many don't wanna get it, but it's great for those of us who want it. So Francesca, I know you're close to it. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm excited as hell. I wanna leave the house. I wanna see people. I realize I don't need liquor every day when I can see a friend, which is interesting. And so yeah, I'm very much looking forward to seeing people. I think at this point though, you know, it's like we know that there aren't really very many side effects other than feeling crappy. And we would have known by now. We probably would have known by now. And yes, we don't know beyond like 6 months or something. Maybe in like, you know, month 12, we all turn into zombies. Or like this is how the X-Men starts. In which case I claim Rogue and that's cool.
That's a pretty good one. I'll be Jubilee. Oh, it sparkles. Anyway, and yeah, the side effects of feeling crappy, like sure, some people get bad side effects. My wife had really bad arm pain from Moderna. Right now, I feel a little bit weird and probably everyone can tell. But I wanna put it in perspective how bad I feel. It's only so bad that I'm not even sure if it's that I got the shot yesterday or that last night I drank champagne and ate a bunch of Americone Dream ice cream. It could be either, honestly. I'm not sure. That's how I feel. A little bit hungover and a little bit like I had too much ice cream. You know? Maybe it's the vaccine. Maybe it's the Ben and Jerry's. I don't know.
How much did you pay for the champagne?
It was actually a gift for our move. So nothing, actually.
Okay, so then it's, well, I'm gonna say bad champagne is the worst hangover.
That will give you a bad hangover, that is true. Now, almost as important vaccine news is that as reported by Cyrus Shahpar, on Saturday, America administered 4.63 million doses in one day. That is amazing. Not too long ago, it was 1 million a day average. That is huge. More than 500,000 doses higher than the previous record, the previous Saturday. And that means that as of Friday, and obviously we now have like 8 million more people since these numbers, more than 112 million people across the US, or a little bit more than 1/3 of the population, have received at least one vaccine dose. And as of Sunday, at least 22% of the country's population had been fully vaccinated. So about 1 in 5 Americans are totally done with this thing, and about 1/3 have received at least one dose. That is good. Even better though, is that more than 78% of people aged 65 and over have received at least one dose of the vaccine and 60% have been fully vaccinated. That is obviously the main reason that the death numbers are dropping as much as they have. And that as cases go up, which we'll get to, the deaths haven't been shooting back up like they have in past spikes. It's because we've done a very good job of vaccinating the elderly.
Yeah. This is like some golden years, that sci-fi movie Cocoon. They are loving it. This is like a renaissance. Older people they're loving life, going out, partying. And I say good for them.
Yeah.
Screw young people. Right. Young people have had their own run. They've been spreading the virus. Now it's the old's turn. The old.
And I love that they're doing it. And I get it. Like they're obviously really scared, but almost 8 in 10 have received at least one dose. That is like Werther's original level acceptance by the elderly in America. That they're like, no, I like it. I do that to me.
Yeah, yeah. That and BBC dramas. It's that and BBC dramas is just
exactly.
I love it. Just love
watching Downton Abbey and sucking on a hard candy. Anyway. Other good news, fewer than 1 in 28,000 people who've gotten a vaccine, or less than 0.004% have reported severe, serious adverse reactions. And by the way, the vast majority who do, and it is rare, do so in the first 30 minutes, generally when they are still being watched at the site where they can be tended to if they have it. But again, 1 in 28,000 is a very low chance of adverse reactions. So that is good news. On the other hand, the US has averaged more than 68,000 new COVID-19 cases every day over the past week. That is about 20% higher than it was the previous week. So cases are still high. In some states, hospitalizations have begun to go up, which is very worrying considering the vaccination. Deaths seem like they're pretty consistent. So again, that race continues, but we're getting more and more good information and vaccination is opening up to more and more people. The fact that California is a huge populous state now, if you're generally old enough that you'd be watching this show, you can probably schedule and go get it in the next few days. That is very good news.
Yeah. No, it's huge. And it is scary though to think about 68,000 cases, right? And I am curious more specifically about where those cases are coming from. And again, you know, a lot of the initial cases were about workplaces and workplace safety. And a lot of folks who are not able to work from home, which, you know, people are should and are still doing if possible. So there's, as we move out of this, John, there's just gonna be so many questions about, you know, who is being protected. I mean, the same folks who have been being, you know, exposed to the virus, essential workers, they're gonna continue to be the ones who are exposed and, you know, fall ill with the virus as well. How are they being protected? And how can we prevent, yes, the next virus, the next pandemic? It's going to be a thing. So good on Biden for rolling this out. Good on Biden for kind of making good and surpassing the promises of vaccination when he first took office. Now I want to see, and I know there is in the infrastructure and the budget, sort of the annual budget, more money for the CDC. I want to see that. I want to make sure that if this happens again, that we're not going to be missing ventilators in hospitals. And I guess the other thing would be two things. One, a plan for national health, and two, a plan to rapidly reduce climate change and all of the things that lead to these viruses leaping to humans from bats and rats and all the other stuff. So huge questions, but yes, so happy that more people are being vaccinated.
Very much so. Great news.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.